In the series of learning programming in C, we are discussing printing pattern programs in C. So, in this video, I am talking about how to print this pattern, right? We have already discussed how to print this pattern like 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? But here the pattern is something different. 1, in second line, no 1, it's 2, 2, then 3, 3, 3, then 4, 4, 4, then 5, 5. And if you have 6, then 6 times 6, then 7 times 7, like this, right? So now, how to print this pattern? See, the same thing, what you will do first? Number of lines, or you can say these are number of rows. Let me divide it, number of rows and columns, and you will get it better. For number of rows, one variable, that is we take I, which is responsible for number of rows. How many rows? 5. When I is 1, this row, then 2, then 3, then 4, then 5. Right? We want 5 rows. Now columns. J is responsible to print, the inner loop is responsible for printing the values in columns. Like J value 1 for this one, then 2, then 3, then 4, then 5. Right? Now here, in this one, in this cell, we are printing 1 and here we are not printing anything. Right? It's not like that now we have to print space here, because in previous video we have discussed that we will print space as well as star. Right? But why so? Because the pattern was something like this. Like this, right? So now before this star we have some spaces, so we have to print these spaces. After that we can print star, but here at starting only I am printing 1, right? So after that no need to print space, you can just simply leave it like this. I hope you got it, right? Now see how you will print this pattern. First of all, the outer loop, which is responsible to print, how many lines are there, how many rows are there? Here I have 5 rows. So the outer loop would be I is equal to 1 to I less than equal to 5 and I plus plus. This is responsible for these number of lines. Now the inner loop, that is J, which is used to print these numbers, right? But here we cannot simply put J is less than equal to 5, some condition, because like in first row J is only executing one time. When I is 2, means for second row J is executing only 2 times, for third 3 times, for fourth row 4 times, and for fifth row 5 times. So J is changing, right? So what condition you will put? See, when I value is 1, J would repeat only one time. When I value is 2, J would repeat 2 times. When I value 3, J would repeat 3 times. Here 4 times, here 5 times. So I hope you are able to relate these conditions, right? So what you can put? J is equal to 1 and J less than equal to I, right? Because of this thing, and J plus plus. Now an inner loop, what you will print? Here are now, we are not printing any star, we are printing some number. So obviously percentage D, integer number I am printing. But what value you will print? Here I cannot print a J. What value you will print? See, here 1 is printing, here 2 times 2, 3 times 3, 4 times 4. 4 times, that would be taken care by the inner loop, means J value is 4, that is why it would be repeated 4 times. And the actual value would be printed here, that is what we will print I. Here I value is 1, 2, for this row I value is 3, and 3 is, I am going to print 3 in this row. For this row I value is 4, and I am printing only 4. For this row I value is 5, and I am printing only 5. Right? So I'd print here I. I cannot print J here. If you will print J in that case, okay, for first line 1 would be printed, but for second line, one user, when control will enter here, J value would be again initialized with 1. So here 1, 2 would be printed. Then 1, 2, 3 would be printed. But I don't want this thing. I want the 2 would be printed, only 2. Fix for second row, only 2. So that is why I am printing here I. I hope you got the working, right? Now slash n for new line, and that's it. Now let's see how it will print. When I value is 1, see, at first I value is 1, right? 1 is less than equal to 5, 5 condition true, we are enter here in this loop, j value is 1. Now 1 less than equal to I value is 1, j is also 1. Condition true, yes, we are enter into this loop. Printf, I would be printed, I value is 1, so 1 would be printed, right? Now what? J plus plus, j becomes 2. Now j becomes 2, is this condition true? No, out of this loop means slash n would be printed, slash n means cursor would go into the next line. Now I plus plus, I value becomes 2. Is this condition true? 2 less than equal to 5, yes, we are again enter here, we will again enter this loop. Now j is equal to 1, j would be again initialized with 1. Now j is 1, I value is 2, 1 is less than equal to 2, yes, condition true, we will enter into this loop and I value would be printed, I is 2, 2 would be printed. J plus plus, 2 less than equal to 2, yes, condition true, we will again enter into this loop, I would be printed, I is 2, fixed value, I is 2 now, again 2 would be printed. Now J plus plus, J is equal to 3, is 3 less than equal to 2, no, condition not true. Enter from the exit from this inner loop and slash n means cursor would go here, right? Now I plus plus, now I becomes 3. So now I guess you can easily understand the working. Now when this 3 3 3 would be printed, then 4 4 4 4 and 5 5 5 5, right? What, once I value becomes 6, 6 is less than equal to 5, no, condition is not true, exit from the outer loop, that's it, right? And if you want, like, user should enter the number of rows you want to print, 5, 10, 15, 20. Then no need to fix this condition. Just take a variable rows or any variable and enter. Ask from the user at the runtime, please enter number of rows you want to print. Using scanf, you can take the data, right? Now, let me show you the output of this program on my laptop. Now, let me create another file for this named pattern5.c, right? Header file, then main function, and now I'll declare the variable I, j, and rows. Okay, now at the runtime I'll ask from the user what, enter number of rows you want to print, right? And how we will take the input using scanf, percentage d, address of the variable is, name of the variable is rows, right? Now the outer loop, that is I is equal to 1 and I less than equal to rows. Now here I am not writing I less than equal to 5 because I am not taking any hard value, like I am not doing hard coding. That is why I am writing here number of rows. The user want to print, that would be stored in the variable name, what, rows. That is why this loop would be till number of rows. Now the inner loop, that is j is equal to 1, j less than equal to what, I, and j plus plus. And now here what will print, simply what, I value. That's it. Now slash n, right? That's it. Now let me run this program and it should ask the number of rows you want to print. See, it is asking enter number of rows you want to print. Now I want, suppose, 5 rows. Okay, it's not printing anything. Why so? Because see, I is equal to I. That is the mistake I have done. I should be 1. Now let me run this. And now it will ask enter number of rows you want to print. Now it is asking enter number of rows you want to print. Let us suppose let's see 5 and 5 rows. Let me run this again for 10 rows. Enter number of rows, that is 10. And that's it. I hope you got it. So now that's it for this video. Now I'll see you in the next video. Till then, bye bye. Take care.